We believe that's exactly the next big mission of hotel software. Why? Simply because hospitality is made for guests, and then nothing seems to be more important than trying to engage them as much as you can. That's really important for the simple reason that you can think of this as another form of revenue management, of maximizing your yield, of maximizing the value of your bookings. Only that doesn't happen by actually yielding, but by actually maximizing the booking value through trying to sell as many upgrades and as many extra services by having a better guest communication. Then by minimizing the risk of getting cancellations on your bookings, and eventually by impressing your guests. And there is one very important aspect. I'm sure you're all fed up of using a lot of different technologies. Today's hospitality technology ecosystem is more or less more complex than that of NASA. You have PMSs, channel managers, rate choppers, any kind of three-letter abbreviations that you don't even know what exactly they do. And I'm sure you don't need another one to try to learn how to use and to synchronize thereafter. So we really will try at least to convince you that this could be done in a really easy way.
This is Alice.
A movie
Alice is a
for
hotel
you.
Manager.
This is Alice. Alice is a hotel manager. Today, Alice is happy because she has just sold another room for the 26th of January. This is Gustav. Gustav is also a hotel manager. Today, Gustav is also happy because he has also just sold another room for the 26th of January. What Alice and Gustav don't know is that they have received the same booking. Gustav thinks that once he sends the booking confirmation, everything is sorted out and his revenue is secured. Alice thinks that nothing is certain until it is certain. She knows that most travelers book more than one hotel just in case and don't make their choice until the very last moment. Just like Lucas, Annika, and their cat here. Alice believes active communication is the way to keep customers, and as soon as they book, her hotel system sends automatic confirmation. A few days later, she sends them a personalized offer for a higher class room at a very preferential price. In a perfect world, it is an automated message which the system compiles and sends based on the actual booking parameters. Then, trying to be as helpful as possible and to save Lucas and Annika the trouble of catching a taxi at the airport, she sends a transfer offer. Again, in the same perfect world, this message is automated and does not actually burden Alice with more tasks. As the arrival date draws near, Lucas, Annika, and their cat make up their mind. Naturally, they choose the hotel that offers the most attention to guests and the best service. So, when they receive the automated prompt to check in on their own, they do it online to save time at the arrival, upgrade their room, and book their transfer, all through the hotel self-service app, which they don't even have to install on their phone. So, just by keeping the communication with guests alive, Alice has beaten the competition and turned a potential booking into a real one. And, in a perfect world, she has done it without lifting a finger, just using the guest engagement features in her smart hotel system. Sadly, Gustav has lost yet another booking. While Alice has not just got it, but generated some ancillary revenues prior to the arrival, which she wouldn't have generated otherwise.
And whom would you like to be? Gustav or Annika? Or Ann, what was the name? Anyhow, let's see some numbers, because numbers rarely lie. The source is really trustworthy. It's Sojourn, one of the experts in online bookings. So they know a lot about online bookings and the behavior of guests when they book. Origin Europe. The numbers are even more convincing for the United States, but we live in Europe, so we're going to look at this. Look at these numbers here. 2/3 of all bookings are actually made more than 30 days in advance. Only 11% are made less than 7 days prior to the arrival. And because I love mathematics, I want to ask you a couple of questions. What's the average length of stay in your properties? Whoever, who's brave to answer first? was the average length of stay of your guests? 1.5, 2 days, how many? 1.8. Let's make it 2, just for convenience. So, just to look again at the numbers, 2/3 of all bookings are made more than 30 days before the arrival, and the average length of stay is, let's say, 2 days. Let's say it's 20 days lead time to 1.5, which is actually the average. Of course, it depends on city, on industry, on the segment of the property and whatever. But the average stay is more than 10 times shorter than the average lead time. So it's clearly a missed opportunity that most of the hoteliers are actually not trying to engage with their guests prior to the arrival. 90% of guests' journey is actually, they remain silent. Most of the hoteliers are actually not taking benefit of engaging with their guests within 90%, as much as 90% of the guest journey. And then there is even more importance in those facts. This is also a reliable source of information. Mirai, look at the cancellation numbers. Booking.com, 40%, 39%, 39%, 36%, on average 39%. Expedia, 25%. Web, 19%. So that simply means that most of the bookings that come with the basis of book now, pay later are actually good intentions. Just like in the movie, frequently people would book a couple of properties. I know people who do that. Literally, they book couple of properties until they decide what their agenda is going to be, whether they're first going to the zoo or whether they're first going to the museum, and then they eventually decide which one to keep. So not actually trying to use that whole period of more than 20 days to engage in guests with guests is also putting the booking on threaten, in danger, because they frequently get canceled, and by deploying a better guest engagement throughout this lead period, we can actually try to minimize the risk of getting these cancellations. Still, most of hoteliers cannot or do not engage with guests, and that's pretty much understandable because technology needs to help them with that. I'm sure that you guys do not dream of hiring someone else, sending messages every day and trying to engage with guests, or buying another solution. So what I'm trying to reveal using all those numbers and statistics is that actually hoteliers need to shift their thinking from stay to journey. It's an important aspect. We all get taught in our universities, in our schools, that actually it is important to try to understand our customers, to try to look through their eyes. It's more important than actually understanding our product. It's more important to understand what they come for. So if we try to look at this, and actually you have your own experience, because you might be hoteliers, but you're also travelers. And you understand that it's a long process. It starts with dreaming about going somewhere. It continues with planning, then it continues with booking, and since the moment of that booking, people anticipate their stay. There are a lot of things that you could efficiently tell them, a lot of things that they could efficiently buy from you, because let's look into another simple fact. You cannot lead a meaningful conversation without a context. When you say hello, and this is the beginning, the booking, you don't tell your entire story. And that's what most of the booking engines today, for example, try to do. They try to sell, they try to upsell at the moment of booking. Why? Simply because they know they're not going to contact that guest before the arrival. This needs to change. This is how, because, by the way, I'm absolutely convinced that each one of you, each hotelier literally around the globe, would agree that they try to create as personalized service as possible to impress guests. But service industry is based on touch points, in satisfying guest needs and touch points. And then let's look at that. This is the traditional. This is what we have now for 90%, maybe more, 95% of all properties. We have a booking, and then we have, I'd call it radio silence. Nothing, literally. Just nothing. And then they arrive, they being the guests. So you have stay, and this is what your typical PMS, your conventional PMS is going to report. Figures about your stay, figures about revenue per available room, but nothing about the missed opportunity right here. By the way, when we initially created this diagram, I found it to be very resembling to a subway map, isn't it? How developed that line of the subways? I find it very immature. And then impressing. We said everyone wants to impress guests with their service, which is great. But then why are we missing 90% of the time of the journey to impress? If you ask most of the hoteliers, they'll also tell you that they strive to offer personalized service. Personalized. And then let's look at the facts. We make a booking, nothing. And what's the first thing your receptionist tell your guests when they arrive? I assume it's guten Tag in most of the cases. And the second, may I have your passport? And the third, may I have your credit card? And the fourth, may I ask you to sign this registration card when the tiny font says, I agree to cover all damages caused to the property, and I agree that my credit card will be charged in case I don't pay for any of my bills. More or less. I'm rephrasing, of course, you've made it sound and look more polite, more politely than I did, but basically that's what happens. Probably, if you look at the time spent by your guests at your reception, which is the first impression for many of them, is it personal or is it formal? Could it be done differently? Could we actually try to relieve the welcoming staff from actually formalities as much as possible and try to focus them on actually socializing and talking to people? How could that be done? Obviously by using more touch points throughout the entire journey. We can have a booking. We can then follow up a couple of days later with allowing them to actually have certain control over their bookings, to manage them easily. Manage them easily. Not just send them a message and ask them to reply to that message. Literally give them the power to manage it easily. Then we can follow up with an upgrade of the room. Would I upgrade the room? Actually, when I, with all my respect to this wonderful property in which we are staying, when I was booking my stay here because I'm staying here for the event, I was surprised that it tried to upsell me a room upgrade at the moment when I obviously selected a certain room type. Come on, can I do it? Am I stupid enough? Could I have missed that offer right now? Wouldn't it be more in the context if they did it 2 days later or just 2 days before the arrival when I might be more inclined to do that? Could we offer some extra that is relevant? We can, but definitely we shouldn't do that at the moment of the booking. Probably in the meantime between the booking and the arrival, we can actually give them some extra incentive, something that will actually make them feel that if they have to cancel a booking, it shouldn't be your property's booking. Can we provide them with some useful info so that they actually build some preference towards coming precisely to your property and do not actually go for the option to cancel the booking if it was a book now, pay later booking? Can we possibly offer them a self-check-in like most of the airlines do? Most of the airlines offer you, actually when I made the booking to fly for this event, I've got, and this is what happens every time with every airline more or less, they'll send you an email suggesting you to upgrade your category. They'll send you an email to suggest you to modify your foot on board. They'll suggest you to add extra luggage or whatever else, as to select your seat, to personalize your entire journey, your entire experience with them. But does it happen with most of the hotels? And may I ask you for something, because it is always very hard just to speak without asking the other side to tell you something. May I ask you, all of you, the last time when you actually had to go to the airport to fly, may I ask you to raise your hands, those of you who actually did not check in online. Those of you who checked in the traditional way at the counter desk. One, two. I think it makes less than 10%. So usually people would go for this kind of stuff simply because they give themselves the possibility to indulge themselves at the time of the check-in, because they can do something else, go shopping or just have a coffee or whatever they like to do. And if that is if that is already done, then we end up with the fact that actually at the time of the arrival we can really welcome them. If we remove the formalities, if we have moved them ahead, if we have asked them to register, if we have asked them to pre-authorize their booking, whatever we wanted to ask them, could actually leave time to your reception staff to welcome them, to socialize, and to provide indeed what we call a personalized service. Then, of course, they can do a lot of stuff while they're in the property. With a smart system that could be really easy to offer them options, to offer them digital service, to offer them self-checkout. And then, very importantly, to ask them a little prior to the checkout, or a little after that. Usually, I'd suggest it a little prior to the departure. Well, you still have time to react in case they were not happy. So you can still do something if you have some information about how happy they are before they arrive. Usually you have those paper questionnaires there, but they don't work because you see them only after they depart. A smart system could actually get this information for you before they depart and whilst you still have time to react. So you understand the point. We can have many touch points and various locations, and we can have various gateways. We can have messaging, sending messages to guests. We can give them the power with smart let's call them web apps, because, by the way, an interesting fact for you guys, I need to differentiate between web apps and apps, because are you aware of the fact that 2/3 of all apps on the app stores on Google and Apple have never been downloaded? 2/3, even by their creators or even by the people who commissioned them. So the technology needs to be smart enough to allow your guest to engage with you without engaging their smart devices with installing another app. So this is all possible with a smart system. Many other industries have applied that. We call it a kiosk. A lot of hoteliers think it's actually a threat for the personalized service, for the human interaction, but it's not, for the sake that it gives another choice to those who want to use it. So we need to start thinking about not just creating multiple touch points, but also creating multiple gateways, like those beautiful emails with active links which lead to beautiful applications, web applications, which allow your guests to take control. You see, it could be something that comes in context, special room upgrade offer, but not at the moment of the booking, a couple of days before that, or even a couple of hours. Beautifully communicated, one click away from making it, then gone. And I can give you many other examples, like allowing them to welcome or to receive a decent welcome, to check in online, to rate your experience with a single click. But I remember I promised at the beginning that I'll try to convince you that's all possible to be done in a really, that's what the slide said, easy way. Because we don't need another application. We don't need someone to key in information about upcoming bookings in order to allow this kind of communication to take place. What I'm trying to convince you is that actually the easiest way to achieve that would be to use one single system, and that's Hotel PMS, for the obvious reason that this system is the only one that captures the entire information about your guests, about their previous stays, about the actual occupancy. Why is that important? It's important because, for example, if you want to suggest, if you want to offer a room upgrade to someone, which is the system that is aware whether you have, at this particular moment of time, whether you have available rooms from a higher category. That's only the PMS. Only that, of course, that shouldn't be the old conventional PMS we all know, which remains for most that is capable of actually handling all that. All information is there. All we need is a smarter design. Tomorrow's PMS will be able to do that. We'll be able to communicate with your guests, and then whenever they take control and decide to do something on their own, we'll bring that back to you right into the PMS so that you have only one single control point, only one single command point through which you control all your operations. Because again, I started with that and I want to draw your attention back to this. Hospitality is made for guests. We don't need management systems that do not put guests in the forefront of all that. Tomorrow's PMS, or I'd say today's PMS, is a system that is capable of doing all that for you. Literally sending messages with active links, getting and taking care of the interactions with your guests on their mobile devices, on the lobby kiosks, on any gateway you may think. It's a matter of fantasy where technology is going to take us. Probably in-room technology, whatever we think. Any device with an internet could become eventually a gateway to engaging your guests. Isn't that marvelous, actually? You can go as close to your guests as their pockets are, because we all wear our smartphones all the time, and we can reach them right into their pocket. So the message is simple. Better guest engagement throughout the entire journey makes you a superstar, impacts your bottom line, and makes your guests happier. And again, this is a better way to build loyalty, better compared to the traditional loyalty programs, because with them you try to buy them materially. If you engage them better in a context, you're actually buying their hearts, and this is invaluable. It's more revenue, it's less risk, it's just better. And as a colleague of mine asked me to use Mr. Trump's new president of the USA style, I would say, it's gonna be great, it's true. So that's it, thank you very much. And if you want to see this in practice, actually, we can invite you to our booth. It's number 18, and we'd gladly show that it's actually already available for hotels in more than 50 countries.